somebody that is very, very happy because God has done this for his favor is able to shout the right hallelujah.
His father, his mother, everything that we were seeing.
The Lord is watching us this morning. And if you see that your Maria is saying, it's a picture song. How many study has been with you already?
Jesus went up to Jerusalem and found
treasures of money in city. And when he had made a scourge of small cords, he drove them all out. Let me say all out.
All out.
Again.
All out.
Again.
All out.
Out of the temple. And the sheep and the oxen, and poured out the changers' money and overturned the tables. Now, turn to God and say, this is Jesus doing this one. This is Jesus doing this one. And this is the Lamb of God. This is the Lamb of God. This is the Lamb of God. Scattering things. And verse 16 says, and said unto them that sold doves, take these things hence, look not my father's house, a house of merchandise. And his disciples remembered that it is written, the zeal of thy house has eaten me up. Verse 18, then answered the Jews and said unto him, what sign showest thou unto us, seeing that thou dost these things? Verse 19. Jesus answered and said unto them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. Verse 20. Then said the Jews, 46 years was this temple in building, and will thou wear it up in 3 days? Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The dimension of today's message is the Lord came to the temple and found people selling doves and doing business and became wild. Was scattering, driving sheep, removing oxen, bringing cane, flogging, and overthrowing through the church. But the direction is, it was the temple of the Lord. And he said, we have built this temple over 46 years. This temple, you say you want to destroy and build back. 46 years. Jesus was not interested in the number of years the temple has been there. Because he was saying, I've been a Christian for 20 years. We started reading together. 50 years I've been a redeemer. When did you go back again? I've been born again for 25 years.
He was not interested in the number of years, but the present state of the temple. Recently, the 46-year-old temple was in a mess. And the Bible says he came and drove all of the things that constituted a problem and a nuisance in his temple all out. Don't be deceived that you've been born again for years. What is your life now? If the Lord comes to you, what will he find? Intruding with his temple that is your body. Because that temple is physical, yours is a temple now that the Holy Ghost lives in. What is in there now?
You know who I am? I've been in the wilderness for 10 years.
I'll shake you. Congratulations.
We started the elders club.
The Spirit of Santa, God bless you. How about now? Tell me, how about now? How about now?
How about now?
Despise means do not get angry at me for trying to beat beat you out of this nonsense. Don't get angry at me for telling the truth. The truth will irritate you now, but guess what? It will help you later.
Amen.
My son, don't despise the chastening of the Lord. Don't get angry at me. Because when God confronts you with the truth, you will get irritated and angry. Is that not true? Yes. Through any means. You may not confront you with your son, and you speak like the Lord, and you get prideful. Who are you talking to? My son, do not despise, don't get irritated, don't run away. I am the one helping you. Neither be weary in this correction. That means he will continue to correct you as long as you live. Don't get tired of it. It's a school. Don't feel as if God hates you. Don't feel as if you've let him down. No. It is his nature to correct you. So when you fall, daddy, please carry me. And he'll pick you. But you have to repent of those ways. Ministers yesterday, that repentance is not saying,
"Oh God, forgive me now. How do I do it?"
You can talk all you want. Everyone said, "We've heard it last year." He's a professional. Heaven is waiting to see that thing you said you won't do again, you start walking separately and a new way. I said, "Now this guy is serious. Release what you have for him." So every time God pledges you on a thing, don't go back there again. Every lesson he taught me, I've been careful to do a new thing. Today the Holy Ghost will fall upon us.
Amen.
Your life. loves you. Don't let Satan deceive you. He loves you so much that he's ready to come down and clean that house. He loves you so much. Don't let Satan deceive you and say, what would you think you are? No, you are a son, you are a daughter, but you need to be cleansed by your father. Jesus. Sin will change us. Sin will make us get less than we ought to get.
Son of God, I believe that you died
and you are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive me just as I am today. Please give me the right to call you Papa. Of my free will, I give you my life. It's yours from now. Take it, Lord, and make it yours. In Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, help me. Let me move. Strengthen me. Change me. Make me a new man. Thank you, Lord, for accepting me. Today, the 28th day of December 2014. Amen. Amen. Let's pray for the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let your heavens open, O Lord.
Amen.
and let your blessings, O Lord, come upon us. Mightily, in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. I'm grateful that we are able to give to you. We are grateful that we are able to dance for you. We are grateful that we are able to walk for you. We are grateful that we are able, oh Lord, to clap our hands and to sing for joy in your presence. We are grateful, oh Lord, that we are here today. We are grateful for your protection. We are grateful for your defense. We are grateful for your provision. We say thank you, Heavenly Lord. What we are doing here is insignificant to all. But we pray that you will accept it, O Lord. And continue to be merciful towards us. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. God has sent again his powerful way. And we need to walk in that word foot by foot. He has said unto us that he is not interested in the years that has passed, how many years we have been in church, that he is interested in our present nature, how we are presently, whether we are still in him or we are straight. I pray that his word will be a mirror unto us, that we will begin to walk and watch ourselves, whether we are rightly walking in his word, whether we are straying, and if we are straying, that we will begin to walk in his way once again, because he's a merciful Father. From Monday to Friday, by 5 o'clock a.m. to 6 o'clock a.m., there was an hour of possibility prayer in this place. And then on Tuesdays, 10 o'clock a.m. to 12 o'clock in the afternoon, we have Jesus' healing room, where God has been healing sicknesses. And then on Wednesday, the church has been fasting from 6 o'clock a.m. to 6 o'clock p.m. Whereas we meet here by 5 o'clock p.m. to 6 o'clock p.m. to pray and break the fast. And then also, every Thursday, we meet here for the teaching and communion service, where we have been taking the blood and the body of Jesus Christ in remembrance of him. And as you take the body and the blood, your life never remains the same. And then also, on Fridays, by 12 o'clock in the afternoon, we have live worship here. You can come here and worship the Most High God, and then you leave here by one, or it can be seen as the Holy Spirit himself directs. And then also by 11 o'clock p.m. on Fridays, we have all night, we have vigil. We gather here to pray for the church, and then for our families also by 11 o'clock p.m. And then we'll meet here again on Sunday, 7 o'clock a.m. for workers, and then 8 o'clock a.m. for those who are not yet workers, as members. And I pray we all come early. And then also I pray that we bring other people to come and benefit from what God has been giving to us Sunday upon Sunday, and then even Thursday upon Thursday, Tuesday upon Tuesday. The church, God has given the church a land, and we are, as we learned today, that we are stewards of the Most High God, and everything that we have is the one who has given it unto us. And on the day of judgment, we will account for everything. God has given us the land, and we are donating, we are giving towards God's land, because that is one of the purposes for which we came to this earth, to take the world for Jesus. And the land is part of taking the world for Jesus. And as you sow into this land, God himself will bless you. Because no one sows into God's activity and remains the same. He said he shall give 100-fold unto everyone who has been sowing unto him. So I pray that we all, as we go home, it will be in our minds that God wants the land, and we are to be part of this land. Whether we are part or not, God says that he will do his work. Because he said he can raise stones unto Abraham. He can raise stones for children unto Abraham. So also we can buy his land, whether or not we are part. But just that we need to benefit for our own selves, not for him. We are not sowing because God needs it, but we are sowing because we need to sow, and it is our purpose. And so if you want to sow, you can pay into the Bank of Africa account, which is behind the bulletin. That is the first account, which is for the church
for God's land and then his building, you can sow into that account, which is for the sake of those who are listening on the internet, 0148812008, 0148812008. And so you can pay into this account, no matter the little you have, God appreciates it. We learned again this morning that if we are born and you sow a little, God is happy with it than the person who has abandoned and then sows a little. And so as we sow into God's church and his land, I can assure you that God will surely bless us and our lives will never remain the same. And then also you can pay your tithes and offerings and every other donation into the other account, Bank of Africa account again. That is 0081018683. I mentioned again 0081018683, Bank of Africa account. And then also we have behind the bulletin the Ustream account, where you can watch every service live on the internet. So today's service, I believe there are people who are watching on the internet live from the beginning to the end. And then also every Sunday by 8:45 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. in the evening, God has been doing what he will do on Top FM 103.1 MHz. Top FM 103.1 MHz. God has been changing lives, he has been transforming lives. There have been a lot of awesome testimonies concerning this radio program. And so as you listen, your life will not remain the same. If you have someone whom you are not able to even bring to church, you can tell the person to listen. You can also open, you can also tune in for the people all in around your area to listen also. And then there's a Facebook account, and then there are other information concerning the church behind the bulletin. Then also every Sunday morning, the church has been sharing the word of God with the prisoners in the Dansoman police station, and then the church has been feeding him. God says that when I was sick, you didn't come and visit me. When I was hungry, you did not give me food to eat. And this is a way of giving food to God to eat. And then also you can sow into that also by meeting Sister Anshari. You can ask your Sister Anshari or any of the ministers. You say you are sowing into the presence fellowship, and God will surely bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Says that where your treasure is where your heart will be. Where you put your mind is where your heart will be. Your mind is in Lotto, your heart will be in Lotto. Every morning you are looking at the papers. May you bless and help meetings. Okay, on the 31st, on Thursday, right? Wednesday. On Wednesday, 31st, yes, Wednesday, thank you. We shall be having a service here from 9 in the evening. Like I said, we shall cross over to 2015 in power.
Yeah!
Did I clap for this? That is what nice. It will be intense, the power of God. And we shall move into 2015 in his power. Then he will tell us what he wants to do in 2015 when we move in. Let's clap for the Holy Ghost. Okay. Your first time today, let me see. My first time today. God bless you. God bless you. Let's clap for Jesus. God bless you. 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 This kindly week after the service, I tell you that the God that we serve, we need to move in your life in a very different way. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Let's clap for Jesus. Amen. And the children are recording.
Papa, thank you so much for your work today.
Let's clap for Jesus Christ.
going to be in heaven plenty.
Children, I'll be ready!
For those of you who first heard, we are, Jesus Christ is the commander in chief. As we say, soldiers respond, sir, not to me, but to him. When we say in the name of Jesus Christ, we say amen. We say, come to God, prayer, then follow us. Are you ready? In the name of Jesus, hold your Lord, Holy Ghost, 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 Holy Ghost,
to your neighbor, the Lord will hold your hands this week.
the one who put your prayers to me. You will not walk in your ways
with me. Like I said, you will not walk in your ways with me. The God who held your face is me. You will not pray. You will not pray. You will not pray. This week he shall be well with you. Not the same day. He shall be well with you. He shall be well with you. He shall be well with you.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our Father, it's not of us but of you.
Yes.
The extent of what has taken place is what our ordinary mind cannot comprehend.
Yes.
I pray for one thing. Open our eyes to see what you have done today.
Amen.
That which you have done today, if we can see a bit of it, our arms will be strengthened in your service.
Amen.
If we can perceive a bit of it, our hands will be strengthened in thy service.
Amen.
We pray for one favor. Open our ears to hear from thy
essence.
Open our eyes to see from thy
essence.
Open our hearts to perceive from thy essence. And let that which you have done today remain permanent. All the days of our lives.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God, we will give you thanks. For the hand of your God is broken. God, we will give you thanks. For the teeth of your God is broken. God, we will bow before you. For the evil eyes monitoring us is blinded. Blessed be your holy name. In the name of Jesus. Because of what you have done today, we are stopping out as kings, and we can never be stopped.
Amen.
We are stopping out as priests, and we can never be stopped.
Amen.
We will return here at the right hand of to continue giving glory unto your Lord. Unto thy servant, you have taken from him, you have distributed to us. As you took from Moses 72 spirits, and you distributed to your servants, so have you taken from your servant this day. Pastor David Elimelu, you have taken grace, you have taken spirit, you have taken power, and you have distributed unto each and every one of us. We pray our Lord and our God, and declare surrender into the hands of the potter. We surrender him and you into your hands. Mount him now. Remount him now. Refill him now. Make him another vessel. A new vessel. A fresh vessel. Fit for the master's use. Because when he is called in this moment, he will be fit for the hour. Make him anew. Renew him. Refresh his strength. In the name of Jesus. Remember Moses' hand was held. Remember all that are holding his hands, financially, spiritually, materially, physically, in the name of a wife, in the name of children. They are holding his hands. Remember them for good. Remember them for good. Remember them for good. In the name of Jesus. Our fathers, we step out. Let our wives and our children, whether they are here or not, see thy glory upon our lives. Our business and our working places, see your glory in our lives. Let every move we shall make from this moment release your glory in Jerusalem. Bless the land of Ghana. Let there be peace in the land of Ghana. Let there be prosperity. Come to the head of state. A new spirit. A new power. Fresh wisdom. In the name of Jesus. I declare the nation blessed.
Jesus. And the nation cannot be
tested.
I declare this nation peaceful. And the nation cannot be counted. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Son.
Thank you,
Holy Spirit. For you have done even more than we requested. Blessed be your holy name.
In
Jesus' mighty name we pray.
The first time you wait behind, I tell you, God will answer this prayer.